of KISS, my very special co-host, all this week on Radio 1990. Welcome, Paul.
It's good to be here. You look better in person than you do on TV, and that's not bad anyway.
Well, I'm glad to have you a week. Today, we've got video music from Huey Lewis in the News, Dead or Alive, and one of Paul's most favorite stars, David Lee Roth.
Right, and to start the ball rolling, here's by far and away the hottest woman in rock and roll today. This is Tina Turner with We Don't Need Another Hero from the movie Mad Max Beyond Thunderdome.
Yeah, birthday candles. This week are Don Henley, 39, Roger Taylor of Queen, 36, former Sex Pistol Paul Cook, 29, and the man with the lips, Mick Jagger. How old do you think he is, Paul?
I don't know, but if rock and roll is the fountain of youth, he's been bathing in it a while. He looks real good.
Yeah, believe it or not, he's going to turn 42 on this Friday. And, you know, he really looked great at Live Aid. You were there. What'd you think about the show?
I thought the show was amazing. It's just important everybody remembers that the music was donated. But everybody really should be sending them money because the cause is really worthwhile. So pick up the phones and send your checks and do what you have to do.
Keep those cards and letters coming in.
You betcha.
When we return, the power of love from Huey Lewis and the News. To the roots, to the place where it all started. Huey Lewis and the News did just that for their new video.
That's right. This is the power of love from the film Back to the Future that Huey Lewis and the News first played in Northern California.
Where'd you start out, Paul?
I think probably in my father's eye, there probably was a little gleam, and then the rest is history.
No, the band, KISS. Where'd y'all start?
We started in a club on Long Island. Long Island.
Long Island. Has KISS ever gone back there?
Well, once the local people found out that that's the club where we started out, they blew the place up.
The club was never the same once you hit it.
That's right. There's a crater where there was a club.
Next up, Lisa Robinson with the first part of her week-long series on the hairstyles of rock and roll. Yeah, it's
good.
Over. Tomorrow, Lisa Robinson uncovers the truth about wigs and rock and roll.
Right. And next, we'll return with one of my favorite videos from Diamond David Lee Roth. So stay tuned.
And stay awake.
Right.
Co-host, all this week on Radio 1990, we asked him for a list of his favorite videos. Now's your chance, Paul. Tell us about one of them.
Well, I'll tell you, if everybody had a sense of humor, we'd probably get through life a lot better, and especially to get through this rock and roll lifestyle. That's one thing you've got to have. And you better believe David Lee Roth has a great sense of humor, and you'll see it a lot in this video. This is just a gigolo. Lets anybody down.
That's right. We'll both be back tomorrow with more video music from Sting, Tears for Fears, and the B-52s.
Plus a trivia question about another of my favorite rockers. I'm Paul Stanley.
I'm Kathryn Kinley, and we'll see you tomorrow.
And I'll see you later.
Oh, yeah. My very special co-host all this week.
Today we've got video music from Sting and the B-52s. Plus, there's a tough rock trivia question from me to you.
So let's get started with Tears for Fears and Shout. His first album, The Hurting, is still a big seller in the record stores.
Not bad. Other groups releasing albums this week include Cheap Trick, The Romantics, John Waite, and Tina Turner.
When Radio 1990 continues, Sting goes solo. Definitely the year for new solo artists. We've already seen work from David Lee Roth and Phil Collins and Freddie Mercury. Have you ever thought of going solo, Paul?
Well, everybody in KISS did solo albums in 1978. Even if I was to do something now, I would never do it at the expense of the band. So if I could do both, probably.
Let me be the first to know.
You will.
The latest musician to go it alone is Sting. His album is called The Dream of the Blue Turtles, and the video, If You Love Somebody, Set Them Free.
With his new band, Late Summer, August 13th to be exact, in San Diego.
Coming up next, part two of Lisa Robinson's week-long series on rock and roll hairstyles. Today, the truth about wigs.
Wigs? What's a wig?
Not us.
Nuh-uh. Just like that blonde's hair.
I hope I never see it. Tomorrow, Lisa Robinson returns with the outrageous hair of Dee Snider.
And I can't wait.
Now it's time for our weekly Radio 1990 trivia quiz. Take it away, Paul.
Right. What rock artist lists John Fogerty and a sexy Russian cartoon character as his heroes? Our musician also grew up both in England and Long Island before gaining success with his first band. What about it? Any guesses?
No.
Stay tuned for the answer.
Artist lists John Fogerty and a Russian cartoon character as his heroes.
The answer is Billy Idol. He was with the band Generation X. He's been successful on his own and made another of my favorite videos. This one's Eyes Without a Face. The thing I like about this one is every time his head gets close to the camera, it blows up. So watch this.
What Billy's up to right now?
Actually, Billy's in the same studio we are. We're about to finish our latest album, Asylum. That comes out September 12th. And he's in the studio at the same time with producer Keith Forsey.
What's that album going to be called?
I don't know, but maybe I'll know by the end of the week.
Good, let me know. That's all for today's show.
Tune in tomorrow when heavy metal rules the day with music from Van Halen, Rat, Twisted Sister, and of course, Kiss.
Of course. See you then.
He's Snyder from Twisted Sister, and if you want to find out the latest in what's happening in heavy metal, you have got to check out Hit Parader's Heavy Metal Hotline, only on Radio 1990.
Radio 1990.
Hi, I'm Kathryn Kinley, and this is my very special co-host this week, Paul Stanley.
I'm having a great time, especially today. Welcome to Heavy Metal Wednesday on Radio 1990.
Today we've got music from Rat, Twisted Sister, and, of course, Kiss.
First up, this is one of my favorite videos from a band having a lot of trouble making another album, at least in its current formation. This is Van Halen with Panama.
Parader Magazine's Heavy Metal Hotline. Since Black Sabbath's reunion at Live Aid, Ozzy Osbourne is said to be looking for some future work with his old band. It will be his current band, though, that appears on his upcoming LP, The Ultimate Sin.
And those waiting for something new from Led Zeppelin? Forecast doesn't look too good. After their reunion at Live Aid, neither Robert Plant nor Jimmy Page would comment on any future plans together. Plant did say the reunion was great fun, but now it's time to return to the present. He added that Live Aid was a worthy cause for Led Zeppelin's reunion, and it was their first appearance since 1980, and it was great.
Heavy metal is attacking the album charts once again. Rat's Invasion of Your Privacy has moved into the top 10, while Theater of Pain by Motley Crue just hit number 18. AC/DC's Fly on the Wall debuts at number 71, while the Scorpions' double set of Worldwide Live jumps into the number 40 spot. The only million seller so far this year has been Perfect Strangers from Deep Purple.
And with the new video, Rat says, lay it down. Today's heavy metal pick, up next.
It's getting bigger and bigger with the release of each of their albums.
Titling the album Invasion of Your Privacy isn't like an offensive thing. You know, we don't mean it as that. We just mean it as, now we are very close to you. You know, we came from just rat to rat, and then we came out of the cellar. So we decided now we're invading your privacy. We're in your homes. We're with your daughters, your mothers, and your sisters. And
Rat's latest record, Invasion of Your Privacy, is already in the top 10. The Boys from California's new video is today's heavy metal pick. It's called Lay It Down.
Robinson returns with her report on heavy metal hairstyles, so stay tuned.
I'm Lisa Robinson in New York. Just when it seemed unfashionable to have long hair, when all of the punks were cutting their hair, all of the heavy metal bands seemed to have it. David Lee Roth had long hair. Dee Snider had long hair, and so did Stephen Piercy. It went along, it seemed, with the spandex pants and the leather and the scarves wrapped around the wrists and the ankles and the whole look. It seemed totally unfashionable, and as such, it was, of course, almost just right for the time.
We work hard, we practice hard, we spend hours putting together a show, and when we play, people are going to pay attention or they're going to get out. It was plain and simple. So we came out dressed insanely. I mean, in those days, it was literally women's clothes. Literally. I mean, because we couldn't afford a fancy costume or to spend $1,000, $2,000 on a costume. What do? To freak people out? You go down to the extra large woman's shop. You know, here's something nice and offensive, and you buy it, and you cut it, and you put it on, and you go out on stage, everybody goes, oh, my God, and it got a reaction. Then once we had their eyes, you know, their hearts would follow, and once you got their attention, then they could see what Twisted Sister, the essence of Twisted Sister, was basically just good time rock and roll, really.
Every time that something becomes passé, you can be sure of one thing, it's going to come back again. Mini skirts were in, then out, now in again. Hair was long in the late 60s, then everyone cut it off. Then that look got tired to a new generation who wanted to look different and wasn't around in the 60s, so they grew it again. Heavy metal bands didn't seem to care that they weren't in style. They had their own style. It eventually became popular, and they looked, to their audiences, just fine. Now that it's been accepted, you can be sure of one thing. Pretty soon, it's going to look all wrong again.
Here's Dee Snider, and you can't stop rock and roll.
Wild hair is kind of the image for a heavy metal artist. Do you think it's important?
I don't know how important it is, but I always figure most of us have long hair because I'm always asleep when the barbershops are open. I don't get up before the sun goes down anyway.
That's a great reason. We continue Paul Stanley's number one video from his favorite group, KISS.
Wow.
He brings you the best in video music.
Paul, what was the first video that KISS made?
I'm not really sure. I don't remember, but we've been doing them since about 1977. The whole idea behind videos originally was when you couldn't tour other countries, you'd send a video in its place.
What is your favorite KISS video?
Well, they're all really special, but Heaven's on Fire is real special. There's a lot of not-so-bad-looking women in there, and somebody's got to take care of them, and it's a tough job, but I've been elected.
Heaven's on Fire. Paul, this is real life, not a video.
That's all for heavy metal this week. Be here tomorrow for video music from the Talking Heads, Culture Club, Aha, Tom Petty, and Weird Al, plus news on the fashions of Brooke Shields.
He's Paul Stanley.
And she's Kathryn Kinley.
We'll both see you tomorrow on Radio 1990. Bye.
Kathryn.
The Talking Heads' new album, Little Creatures. Paul, did you know that KISS and the Talking Heads have a few things in common?
Really?
Really. Well, both bands were formed in New York within a few years of each other.
And both bands have four members, right?
Right.
Well, keep talking, Kathy.
Anyway, Talking Heads' newest video takes us on the road to nowhere. Well, we know. Rock and roll hairstyle of Boy George.
It's waiting.
Of gender bending. But KISS's makeup was a little more theatrical. What's the difference?
Well, I guess it's just all different ways to get the audience off, you know. We were maybe more theatrical than feminine. I don't mind getting into a dress, but it's got to be on a woman.
I agree. Next up on Radio 1990, news on the fashions I've been wearing all this week from Brooke Shields.
You look great.
You a little about the new designs from Brooke Shields that I've been wearing all this week.
She really looks great. Her neck's a little thin.
Paul.
Sorry.
Brooke has just started marketing her own line of jeans, big shirts, and mini skirts. So whether it's denim, corduroy, or cotton fleece, Brooke has got affordable clothing for you. Tell me, Paul, now that Brooke Shields has got her own fashion line, what are the chances for a KISS line?
Well, I think any day now we're going to come out with a line of KISS lingerie, negligees, accessories, the kind of stuff you can take home for a little bedroom party.
But I don't think I can wear them for a week of fashion featuring here, can I?
No, but you could wear them later.
Okay. Let's end today's show with another of your favorite videos.
Okay, this is Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers. It's one of my favorites. This is Don't Come Around Here No More. This woman's a piece of cake. Let them eat cake.
Tune in tomorrow when Paul Stanley and I go to the movies to see Mad Max Beyond Thunderdome, Explorers, and E.T.
We've also got video music from KISS, Patti LaBelle, and Michael Sambello.
Plus more from Lisa Robinson on Rock and Roll Hairstyles. See you then.
See you then.
Kathryn Kinley's clothes have been provided by Brooke Shields.
Hi, I'm Kathryn Kinley.
And I'm Paul Stanley. Welcome to Radio 1990. Bet you didn't know today's Mick Jagger's 42nd birthday.
Happy birthday, Mick. Today we've got video music from KISS and Patti LaBelle. Plus Lisa Robinson with the final part of her week-long series on rock and roll hairstyles.
We'll also get to go to the movies to see Mad Max Beyond Thunderdome, Explorers, and E.T. Let's kick off the day with Gravity from Michael Sambello and the film Cocoon.
Been dying to ask you all week.
Really, what is it?
What has KISS been up to?
Well, we're just finishing up our latest album. Should be out in September, and it's another bit of sonic devastation. This one's called Asylum.
Are you going to be touring anytime soon?
Probably the end of November. We should be going out with our biggest show yet.
Oh, great. Well, we continue Lisa Robinson's report on the classic hairstyles of Patti LaBelle. He goes to the movies.
We're going to see Mad Max, E.T., Explorers. Stay tuned.
Three movies perfect for your summer fun. The first is Explorers. Imagine, one night you dream about a spaceship that can take you to the stars. You tell your best friends. One who designs the ship, the other who builds it.
Why don't we call it... We'll call it the Jules Bird.
No, no. We could call it the Einstein. Now that's a great name.
Oh, come on.
Come on. What do you want to call it? The Lori Swinson?
Well, I have an idea.
And what's that?
How about The Thunder Road? It's from a Bruce Springsteen song.
It's not bad. Not bad, it's perfect. The Thunder Road. I christen thee The Thunder Road. The Thunder Road! Based on a dream by Ben Crandall.
Let's go.
Well, I was sort of hoping to do with this picture something a little different than I've been doing by making a picture that's it's a little bit more relies on character maybe than little guys in green suits and stuff that I've been doing. Also, I like working with kids, and it's got three kids in it who were all really a lot of fun and quite a revelation to work with.
Next time we'll bring more air.
We'll go higher, and we'll explore.
Listen, Ben, I'm not going to get in that thing again until we find out exactly where those programs are coming from. And we need to run tests.
Yes, we have to run hundreds upon hundreds of serious tests.
You know, it could take years.
What are you talking about?
That was the most important thing that ever happened. How couldn't you feel it? That feeling way inside?
It makes some sense. We almost didn't come back,
but we did come back.
Here we are.
What do you think? We should trust the dream, right?
Sorry, man. I want to live.
One of Spielberg's biggest hits returns to movie screens today, E.T. When we return, we'll finish up our week with Paul Stanley and Lick It Up from KISS. When was the first time that KISS took off their makeup for a video?
Well, we've done a couple in hotels on different tours, but nobody's ever going to see those. The first one you'll see on TV is probably Lick It Up.
Well, why'd you do it?
Well, everything has its time, and we decided to leave the makeup behind and go on to bigger and better things.
Here's a look at KISS, naked before the cameras for the first time with Lick It Up.
That's all for Radio 1990 this week. Be sure to tune in next week.
It's been great having you here all this week, Paul. Thanks a lot.
Oh, it's been great having you, too.
To keep rocking this weekend, tune into Night Flight for Guitar Heroes, video profiles on Lou Reed and Marianne Faithfull, and a special look at rock in the movies.
Plus, Magical Mystery Tour and Smithereens.
Again, Paul, thanks for being my guest.
It's been great.
See you on Monday. Have a great weekend.
Kinley, Wendy O. Williams.